Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. So today I decided to talk about how to store your fresh produce or vegetables in the fridge to make it last longer. This means there won't be any wastage and we can save money and eat healthy. We have a small fridge. It's a 320 liter higher refrigerator. Generally, we try to buy vegetables in smaller quantities so we can accommodate it better. However, there are times when vegetable shopping frequently isn't possible with our busy schedules. These are some vegetables I got delivered today, and here's how I store them in my small fridge. I realized storing vegetables as it is takes up a lot of space in the fridge because of its length and volume. Hence, cutting and storing them makes it easy to accommodate as well as reduce the cooking time. I like to store the ridge gourd only peeled and not cut so that it gives me the flexibility to cook any recipe I want. I'm also cutting pumpkins so that I can store it in a container. I will cut them into two sizes, one in cube size for sabzi and some long slices to make pumpkin pakora or fry. I'm also cutting broccoli into florets because I'm going to cook it within 2 days, but if you want to store it longer, I suggest you wrap it with a cling film or you steam it and store it to make it last longer in the fridge. For okra or bhindi, this is the best way I found to store it. It lasts up to a week and sometimes more. I'm going to store it in two different containers, unwashed and uncut. I will separate smaller sized and larger sized bhindi because I'm going to make bhindi kurkure or fry with the smaller sized ones and bhindi sabzi with the larger sized ones. For any kind of brinjal or eggplant and cucumber, you can wrap it in a kitchen towel and that helps to absorb moisture and keeps it fresh for a few days. Now let's talk about this everyday use items. Here's a trick I found to store lemon. Lemon is something we always use for a lot of things, but it tends to rot very fast. Soaking lemon in some water and storing it in a container will make it last very long. It keeps it fresh that way and maintains its juiciness. You can change the water every 2 to 3 days. For curry leaves, I always wash and dry it in the sun, then store it in a container with a paper towel underneath. I just find it convenient to use this way, though a lot of you have told me I can also store them as it is in a container. For green chilies, removing the stems and storing it in a container with paper towel makes it last very long. The kitchen towel basically helps in moisture absorption. For garlic, I get this pre-peeled garlic cloves and store it in the same way with a paper towel underneath. The price is actually double compared to the unpeeled garlic. However, I think weight-wise it makes sense and also it's very convenient if you want to save that amount of time. For mint leaves, store them in a bottle unwashed with a paper towel underneath and also another paper on top of the container. And that way it stays fresh for 3 weeks to a month. For ginger, I like to wash it well and then dry it in the sun for a day or two and then store it in the fridge. That way I can just grab it and smash it right away for our daily morning and evening tea. I make homemade ginger garlic paste and store it in the freezer, which I would be showing you guys in one of my upcoming meal prep videos soon. During summers, it's a task to store banana. It rots so fast. One trick I found to make it last longer is to wrap it with aluminium foil to store it on the countertop. However, summers are also a good time for smoothies, and I generally don't like to eat banana as it is unless it's in a smoothie or mixed in a recipe. Hence, this works for us. You can freeze banana in a container in the freezer and it stays good for quite a long time. These are some of the best tips I found to store leafy greens in the fridge. Spinach is something which gets spoilt in a few days if not stored in the right way. I use an airtight container with a paper towel underneath and then store the spinach unwashed in that. I promise it will last you easily for 2 weeks or more. I will do the same thing for methi leaves and amaranthus leaves too. This is how I store my coriander leaves. I do the same thing with that, put a paper towel underneath and store it in these containers. I like to buy coriander leaves in more quantity since I make green chutney with that and use it in a lot of my recipes like pulao, sandwich, biryani or chaat, etc. This space you see here on the right hand side is left empty for keeping the leftover food whenever we have any. This is one vegetable in my house which Kaya and my little fur baby loves to eat. It's hilarious to see them eat it together. So I buy carrots in larger quantity, but then I also need to store them smartly or else it can easily go bad fast. I store them in an airtight container, soak them fully in water, and that way it can be kept fresh for a month. However, you need to keep changing the water every few days. I also wash, peel and cut them in long and store them in a container. This way it's easy for Kaya to grab a few whenever she wants. This usually doesn't last more than a few days. However, if you want to store it longer, the first method is better. I also store baby corn in a bottle, unwashed and uncut, with a paper underneath. This way it stays fresh for long. For coconut, there are various ways to remove coconut from its shell. Some told to roast the whole coconut on the gas flame for a while and that way the flesh would come off easily. It's easier than cutting it into pieces using a knife, just like you see it here. Or easiest is to use a coconut scraper like this. We use coconut for chutneys or at times to make some homemade dessert. We don't use them in daily cooking though. So I like to store it in the freezer. Storing them in the freezer makes them last long, and whenever I need it, I just take the container out, take out the amount required and immediately put it back in the freezer. This really helps to keep it fresh and you can try it out. Check this out. It's been a week now with the brinjal wrapped and stored. It's way fresher than it would be without the wrap. Also, I don't throw the paper towel. I reuse it for my kitchen cleaning purpose. Here's one more tip for brinjal. So when we cut brinjal, it always turns black in a few minutes. So to avoid that, soaking it in the water with some salt and 2 tablespoons of milk helps to stop its discoloration. Also, here's another tip. For example, here I'm going to use half quantity of the cut brinjal and the other half I'm going to cut and store it in a container with some sprinkles of lemon juice. I'm going to make some sabzi with that the next day. This lemon juice will keep it from turning black. However, you have to use it in a day or two. I'm going to make a quick stir fry with them. It's been a week and the bhindi is still fresh. Here's a quick recipe of my kurkure bhindi. We need to wash and dry the bhindi well first and then cut them into half. In a bowl, I added some besan, salt, pepper, jeera powder, chili powder, haldi and a little bit of water. Mix the bhindi with it and deep fry till brown. And I'm going to make bhindi masala with rest of the bhindi in the fridge like I told you before. Look at this banana. It still didn't turn black. Those busy mornings when Kaya has her classes and she needs to have something before her class, yet not something which will take time to eat, this smoothie is a savior. To the frozen banana and milk, you can add some honey too. I didn't add that because the banana itself was sweet enough. Here's how the Amaranth's leaves look now. It has started to go a little bad, so I need to cook it today. While I was cooking, I realized it was too less, hence I added some methi leaves too. Spinach is the winner among all. This is so fresh even after a week stored in this way. I'm going to make a quick palak paneer with it now. This coconut cut and stored really helps with a quick breakfast. I'm going to make a coconut chutney with my dosa and our breakfast is sorted. And that's it for today's one. I hope you found this helpful and will try them out soon. And let me know if it worked for you in the comment section below. And I'll see you all soon. Thank you for watching. Bye.